Happy Thursday, Thriving Thursday. It is already December the 19th, 2019, and we are getting right into this fourth day of the week. Welcome. Let's get into this daily fresh tarot card reading. Drum roll, please. Now, we've got a couple of cards that I was led to pull. I pulled the Message from Guides cards. I was led to pull two of those. And then I have two of our Rider-Waite standard cards. Now, welcome North Node Tribe and welcome new subscribers. Let me clarify a couple of things. The daily tarot card reading comes on a daily basis, okay? It may or may not resonate with you. It's a general reading. So if you're coming on a daily basis, you will see how they flow in together and tie in together. And you, if you're journaling like we do here over at As Magical Practitioners, you will see how they tie in together and they will resonate with you. So if you feel like you need to, if you're a new subscriber and you're clicking dislike, it's probably because you don't understand that this is a general reading. If you want a personalized reading, you need to schedule an appointment with me so that we can do a one-on-one personal reading that is intuitive and mainly focused on you. But welcome new subscribers. It's like, this is not a pick me card reading. This is led by the divine, the source, the spirit guides. I put in a lot of energy directed for this particular channel. It's a special channel and is a bridge from one group of people to moving into occultism and knowing their higher frequency. So let's get it in. Today's daily card for today, pull is the Three of Swords. And we have as the Clarifier as the Emperor card. I also have two cards that are from the Message Guides that I'll be going over as well. That's tying into today's daily reading, okay? So with this Three of Swords, what the Divine and Source is saying is that you don't have to accept, and that's my angels when I start doing that, you do not have to accept the words that others are saying to you as the golden rule, you know, as the gospel, as the truth. This is merely a projection of their own fears and their own anxieties, okay? So use this as an opportunity to turn the tables and be passionate to those individuals. Be mindful of why this is triggering you as well. Why are these things that are being said to you triggering your own emotions? Why is it have you heightened and very upset? All right. Even though it's a projection from their own fears and anxiety, but why is it triggering you? So this is where you have to show compassion and understanding. Now, this can be tailored from a person in relationships. It can also be tailored in from what I'm getting as well from a job aspect, or how you feel about getting this new job, or how you feeling being rejected from a job opportunity. As well, it is tying into how you overall are projecting yourself, because there's a lot of sensitivity going on right now due to the astrological forecast as well, which I'll get in. So as a clarifier, the Emperor card comes in today that this individuals are strongly opinionated, but is their own projection of themselves. It's their own projection of themselves, and they're very opinionated. So you have to take some steps back and know that this is their fear and their own projection of themselves. And sometimes when people are very opinionated and coming at you, lots of times there's different things that's going on with them that they have decided to take it out on you. And sometimes, depending on where you are energetically, you may be more vulnerable to receive these messages concerning them and it being an offset of you, and you needing to take time and dig deep on yourself to know who you are. Even when challenges are coming to you, you have to know how to project that energy back to them, but do it with compassion. Sometimes you don't have to respond verbally. Sometimes you do, sometimes you don't. Sometimes you just have the best way to respond in some situations is to remain silent. And then they'll see that it's a projection of their own fears and their own anxieties about what's going on with them. As well, We are in a season that we're going through what? Sifting. We have been sifting a lot, going through sifting, all these different challenges that are as creating us to be better so that we're moving into this new decade in strength and ambition and being bold to know who we are. Right. So as the message from the guides were giving me today to tell me to pull these cards, one area that the guides wanted to say is to forgive yourself. Forgive yourself during this sifting time and forgive yourself of different things that you have been going through all year long or possibly this past month of challenges. You know, you're looking at yourself and seeing, is it my fault? Is it my fault? Some things is just a matter of choices. Some things is just us going through a learning pattern to understand certain things and to say, hey, I forgive myself, because the guides are saying, forgive yourself. The other card that the spirit guides wanted to bring is, you are never alone. You are never alone. And I'm going to bring that closer. You're never alone. You have your spirit guides, guardian angels, your ancestors, many of people that are supporting you. They are rooting you on in the clouds. They are rooting you on all around you. You have an army of spirit guides and angels and ancestors that are rooting you on and wanting the best for you. So you are never alone, especially when we're coming into a season. Sometimes people haven't gotten over loved ones that have gone on, you know, have transitioned out of this physical life. Some people are going through transition in relationships and they feel like they are alone. But you are never alone. You have many people that love you, that believe and trust in you, and they rely on your energy because you are a vital part of their life. And if anybody else don't tell you that, then you are a vital part of their life. You're a vital part to me coming to this channel on a daily basis, me being able to share an inspirational message from the divine, the source, the spirit guides, and me knowing that I'm energetically exchanging with you and knowing that I'm part of your universe and believing and trusting and knowing that you are who you are and just be who you are, okay? Because that's why we're here. You didn't stumble on this channel. You didn't. It wasn't a coincidence. You are here for a purpose to hear these messages, all right? So we want to reiterate that you are not alone. Okay, do not take these holiday season that's upon us as having a certain feeling or a vibration of whether you're not able to give. This is kind of give a present or something like. You are a present. You are a walking, talking present because you're able to give a part of who you are. And that is ultimately agape love, which is love. And that is the true gift in any kind of season because you are a gift all together. So know you're gifted in who you are. So click that wiggly bell down below, ding dong ding, to make sure you're getting the daily fresh tarot card reading that's coming to you at a daily basis. Know that this is just a cloudy point of view from others. It's a cloudy point, and that's what the title. It's just clouds that's coming through. So let that pass on by you, okay? Don't forget to contact me for intuitive readings that will change your life, because they are intuitive readings that will change your life. When you come to get a reading, it is intuitive, it is genuine, and I also expect clients to bring their genuineness too in the readings. It is private, it's confidential, and it's one-on-one. It's about quantity and quality, most important. So you come to share and be open and don't hold back, even as the spirit guides give information, so that you can be free during the intuitive readings. That's what it's all about. Don't forget that we offer conjure work that will change your life, okay? That is another area that we offer. We offer multitudes of teaching and so much more that is coming in to 2020. All right. So don't forget to go to the astrological forecast later on this afternoon. I will have it up, and we do have a live coming up and so much more following into this winter solstice that's coming upon us this weekend. Okay. So in all things, I love you so very much. Don't forget to dig deep and trust in yourself who first. And for some reason, the divine keeps telling me that, and all you're getting, get understanding. So whoever that is for, you know what that's for, and all you're getting, get understanding. Okay. So apparently somebody needs to get some understanding while you're here. All right. So I love you very much. Continue to dig deep, and don't just be busy. Be what? productive. I'll see you next time. Bye-bye.